CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 1.
Hello children, I am Neeraj and this is Kulvinder with me.
Hello everyone. Hi kids. Today we are going to talk about class 1 shapes and space.
Yes, and we will discuss about on and under,
above and below.
Yes. So let's begin with this
chuk chuk train. Oh, what is that sound?
It says chuk 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 chuk.
Oh yes, it is a train.
And name of this train is Good Morning Train. This Good Morning Train has come to say hello to you all.
Hello.
Good Morning Train has come to say hello. Hello. Good Morning Train has come to say hello.
Choo. Choo. Choo.
Good Morning Train has come. Good Morning Train has come.
Good Morning Train has come to say hello.
Choo. Choo.
Now, hello to the babies sitting on the floor today.
Hello.
Good morning to the babies sitting on chairs today.
Hello, babies.
Good morning to all the lovely babies sitting on the sofa today.
Hello to you all.
Good morning and hello to the babies sitting on the bed today.
Hello.
And namaste to the babies sitting on stool today.
Hello to you also.
A lovely hello to the babies sitting on the mat today.
Hello everyone.
Now Good Morning Train is going back. Bye-bye, Good Morning Train.
Bye-bye. See you.
So today, we are going to talk about on and under. What is the meaning of on?
And what is the meaning of under?
How do you spell on?
O-N, on.
And U-N-D-E-R, under. On and
under.
Actually, these words are used to tell the position of one thing with respect to another thing. Like we have learned inside, outside, bigger, smaller, top, bottom, nearer and farther. These are the words that tell us about the position of a thing with respect to another thing.
For example, the camel was inside the tent and the man was outside the tent. We have done it. Do you remember? Yes, I know. You do remember. Okay, now tell me, where are you right now?
Are you inside a house or outside a house?
Are you inside a room or outside a room?
I know about myself. I am inside this tiny room.
Yes, I am also inside this room.
Okay, now, let me tell you a story. Do you want to listen to a story?
Yes, I love listening to stories. And so do my kids.
Yes, but Kulvinder, do you know Whenever we listen to a story, we must maintain a good posture.
Good posture? What do you mean by that?
Good posture. It means you have to keep your back straight.
Okay, kids. So, sit straight, back straight, and if you are comfortable, you can fold your arms.
Yes. Now that you are ready, let me tell you a short story.
Yes, we are ready.
Have you heard about the story of monkeys and the cap seller?
What happens in the story?
Okay, let me tell you. Once upon a time, there was a cap seller.
Cap seller? Who is a cap seller?
A person who sells caps.
Caps? Oh, that we wear on our head.
Yes.
I have a red cap.
Great. So, one day he took a big basket, a tokra with him. It was full of caps. Red caps, blue caps, green caps, yellow caps and many more. He went to sell the caps. It was very sunny. He got tired. He was sweating. Oh, it is so sunny today. So, he kept the basket under a tree and slept for some time. There were some monkeys who were sitting on the tree. They wanted to see the caps because they were so colorful. They wanted to take the caps. So, they got down slowly. And took all the caps on the tree.
Oh, what will the cap seller do now? What will he sell? The monkeys have taken away all the caps up on the tree.
Yes. And you know, Kulvinder, after some time, the cap seller woke up and he found his basket empty. Then he looked at the monkeys. They were wearing all the caps.
Oh my God! His all caps?
Yes. And he said, "Oh God, my caps!" shouted the cap seller. He wanted his caps back. He asked the monkeys to return the caps. "Please, please give me my caps back. Please give me my caps back. I want my caps. Please give it back to me." But the monkeys were jumping here and there. Then he got an idea. He took his own cap from the head and threw it on the ground.
But why did he do that?
Let's see. He took his cap from the head and threw it on the ground. The monkeys, they also did the same. They threw their caps on the ground.
Oh, monkeys copy what they see.
Yes.
They saw the cap seller wearing a cap. They wore the cap on their heads. When the cap seller threw the cap off his head, they also threw their caps down on the floor.
Yes. And what did the cap seller do? He quickly moved and he gathered all the caps and went back home happy.
Oh wow, good.
he was smart.
Very clever.
Yes. Okay, Kulvinder, have you listened to this story attentively?
Yes, it was very interesting.
Now tell me, where were the monkeys? Where were the monkeys sitting?
So kids, where were the monkeys sitting? The monkeys were sitting on the tree.
Yes, you are right. They were on the tree.
All the kids told me this answer. They were listening to the story very attentively.
And what sound does the monkey make? Yes. Now next question for you. Where did the monkeys put the caps?
The monkeys put the caps on their heads.
Yes, on their heads. And do you remember when the cap seller was sleeping, he was snoring? What was that sound?
That was the sound of sleeping.
Can you make that sound?
Let's try it, kids. Oh my god, I can't snore.
Okay, now tell me, where was the cap seller sleeping like? Where was the cap seller sleeping?
Where was the cap seller sleeping? Yes, I know. The cap seller was sleeping under the tree.
Yes. Okay, now let's understand it like this. If we ask the question where, the answer we get is the position of that thing. For example, the monkeys were sitting on the tree. Where were the monkeys sitting? On the tree.
The monkeys were sitting on the tree.
Where?
On the tree.
We can say O and on refers to a position where one thing is covering another thing. It usually touches the surface of another thing. It means that if there are two objects, one is upper and the other is lower. When the upper object rests itself on the lower object, we use O-N.
On.
O-N.
On.
Like, I am sitting on this chair.
And I am sitting on this sofa.
My mobile is on the table.
Apples are on the tree.
Yes, apples are on the tree. There are two objects here. Apples and the
tree.
Apples are touching the tree and they are covering some part of the tree. Therefore, we say apples are on the tree.
Yes.
Usually, the upper object is smaller than the lower object. In this case also, the apples are smaller and the tree is bigger. Because a bigger object can easily carry the smaller object. When the apples get ripened, जब सेब पक जाते हैं, they start
falling down.
What do?
They start falling down.
Right. So the fallen apples are no longer on the tree. Where are they now?
Now, as they have fallen, they are on the ground.
Yes, they are touching the ground now. So we can also say that fallen apples are under the tree.
Yes, they fall on the ground under the tree.
Yes, this is a new relation. Under, U-N-D-E-R, under the tree.
I tell you, Neeraj, one day my pen fell and I found it under the bed.
You know, I remember one day I was playing with the ball and it went under the sofa.
Oh, and you see, a stool is kept under the table.
Yes, and while taking a bath, I put my bucket under a tap.
Yes, these are some of the examples of under.
I think the kids would now have understand the usage of on and under.
Yes.
Okay, Kulvinder, I know a game where we can use on and under with concrete objects.
Game?
Yes, a game.
How can we play that?
For this game, we need some objects. Like you can keep your toys, a small animal, a rubber, eraser or pencil.
I have so many objects in my basket. Let me bring that.
Okay, so now what you have got?
I have got so many toys, a ball, a car, a bus. Here it is, a truck, a baby elephant, a teddy bear.
And this color box?
Yes, I have crayons in this.
And you have a spoon too.
I have this small dish also.
Yes, great. So now that you have collected all the material, let's see how we can play this game. You have to take a table, a small table. If you don't have a table, no worries. You can use a plate, a cardboard, or a big book. What you have to do is, you have to place the cardboard or the book like a table on the top of something.
I know. I always make a table like this. I keep two books on the side and I put a board over on it. And it gives it a look like a table.
Yes, kids love making castles like this.
Yes.
So now that your table is ready, let's begin the game.
Yes, let's start.
Now, you will do as I instruct you.
Okay. So kids, are you ready?
I guess they are ready.
Yes, they are.
So, take out. So, pick one object from your basket.
Here, I love this car. A red car.
So, now, put this car on the table.
Put this car on the table. That means, I have to put this car up on the table or the cardboard.
Yes, the table you have just made.
I have placed it on the table.
Here I can see that the car is there on the upper part of the table.
Yes.
Now, take this spoon and put this under the table.
And this spoon is kept under the table.
Great! So you have kept the spoon under the table. That means on the lower side of the table.
Under the table.
Yes, under the table. Now, take this color box.
This color box. And it has so many different colors in this.
Yes. Put this color box under the table.
The color box under the table.
So kids, whenever you play this game, you need to speak where are you keeping the object. Is it on the table or under the table? So say simultaneously.
If we are keeping the object on the table, We must say, I am keeping this on the table. Likewise, if you are keeping a ball under the table, then you say, I am keeping this ball under the table.
Yes. Now, take this geometry box and keep it on the table.
This geometry box. And I am keeping this geometry box on the table.
Next is a ball. What is the color of this ball?
This ball is of red color.
You had red car and now red color ball?
I love red color.
Okay, now put this red ball under the table.
This red ball under the table.
Next, take this pencil and keep it on the table.
I have this blue pencil.
Now, keep it on the table.
I am keeping this blue pencil on the table.
So, let's make this game more fun. I will instruct you what you have to put, but now I will do quickly. Are you ready?
Yes.
Quickly.
Yes, kids, we are ready.
Okay, now put this bangle under the table.
Bangle under the table.
Eraser on the table.
Eraser on the table. Now I cannot talk, kids. I cannot tell you the color of my eraser because I have to do the things very quickly. Yes, Neeraj.
Plate under the table.
Plate under the table.
This baby elephant on the table.
Baby elephant on the table.
Great. So now put this small bottle under the table.
Small bottle. Big bottle? No. Small bottle under the table.
Great. So you have not made a single mistake.
I have learnt what is under and what is on.
Kids, you can also play this game with your siblings, your mother, father, or anybody at home. You can speed up the instructions as you play the game further.
And don't worry even if you make a mistake. You can again pick up that object and keep it under.
Yes, that you can make more challenging by speeding up your game.
Yes.
So, kids, we saw the usage of on and under. Let's move on to above and below.
What is above and below?
Something on the upper side is known as A, B, O, V, E, above.
Like you told us it was on.
Yes, let's see what is the difference.
Oh, it is different from on.
Yes.
A, B, O, V, E. Above.
And opposite of above is below. Something that is on the lower side is below. B, E, L, O, W, below.
Below. B, E, L, O, W. Below. The opposite of above is below.
Above, below.
Below, above.
So let's do it with our body.
Our body?
Yes. What do we all have on our face?
On our face, I have eyes, nose, lips, chin, cheeks, a mouth.
Right. So, if I ask you what is the position of your eyes on your face, keep the nose as the center point. Now tell me, where are the eyes placed on your face?
Nose is the center point. Eyes are above the nose.
Yes, eyes are placed on the upper side of the nose. Can we say that eyes are above the nose?
Yes, eyes are above the nose.
And vice versa, our nose is below our eyes.
Oh yes, our nose is placed below our eyes.
Because our nose holds a lower position. But the difference here is that eyes and nose are not touching each other.
Oh yes.
Now think, what is the position of our mouth? Is it above or below our nose?
My mouth is below my nose.
So does it hold an upper position or lower position on our face?
A lower position.
So it is below our nose.
Yes, our mouth is below our nose.
Yes, A-B-O-V-E, above, refers to the position of being in an upper or higher place. It is used for something that is higher than something else, something placed up. Here also, the relation is between two objects, one upper and another lower, and they do not touch each other.
They do not touch each other.
Size of the two objects does not matter. Because they are not touching each other, so one object need not carry the weight of the other object.
I can keep my left hand above my right hand.
But they should not touch.
Yes, if it is touching, then my left hand is on my right hand. But when it is not touching, my left hand is above my right hand. There is gap between the two hands.
You are very smart, Kulwinder.
I have learnt it from you.
Okay, now tell me, the sky and our head, two objects. The sky and our heads.
The sky and our heads.
So, is the sky on our heads or above our heads?
Oh no, there is so much space between the sky and our head. So, I feel the sky is above our heads.
Yes, you are right, because the two objects are not touching.
Yes.
The ceiling fan.
The ceiling fan is above Kulwinder.
Yes, the fan is running above Kulwinder. What about the clouds? Have you seen clouds?
Yes, I have seen black clouds when it is about to rain.
So clouds, are they on us or above us?
I see a scenery. The clouds are above the hills.
Yes, the clouds are above the hills or village or city.
Yes.
Have you seen flowers and butterflies?
Yes, I have seen very colorful butterflies flying over here and there.
Yes. So, when a butterfly is searching for nectar, she is just looking at the flowers, taking its fragrance. So at that time, is the butterfly above the flowers or on the flowers?
It goes on from one flower to another. It sits on the flower, then it moves on to another flower.
Yes. So when they are flying, the colorful butterflies are above the flowers.
Yes. They fly above the flowers and then they sit on the flower to take the nectar out.
So, when they are flying, they have not sat. They have not touched the flower yet. They are still checking which flower is best. Therefore, the butterflies are above the flowers and the flowers are below the butterflies.
Yes, the flowers are below the butterflies.
Have you seen any tree?
Yes, I have seen a mango tree.
I'm sure, kids, you have also seen trees and plants. Roots of most of the plants can't be seen, like carrots. Can you see the carrot?
No, we can see it only when we get it into our homes.
Yes, but when it is under the ground, we cannot see a carrot because it is below the ground in soil. Plants can be seen, like the leaves of a carrot plant can be seen because they grow above the ground.
Yes.
So now, kids, I hope you understand the meaning and usage of on, under, above, and below. O-N?
On.
U-N-D-E-R?
Under.
A-B-O-V-E?
Above.
B-E-L-O-W?
Below.
So, this is Neeraj saying bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
So friends, you were just listening to the series Dhwani Shala. Production assistants, Meenakshi Kukreti, Tanu Gupta and Jagbandhu Jana. Recorded by Bati Lang Lingdo. Produced by Ajit Horo. This series was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.